A sick irony would be if the U.S. did actually withdraw forces from Iraq under pressure. That's exactly what Iran has wanted. In terms of ISIS, though, what is the potential for ISIS to come back as they did the last time U.S. forces pulled out?
Well, if you think about why we have troops in Iraq to begin with, it's right now it's mostly because we want to control ISIS, to go after the remaining pockets of ISIS that still exist. There's still networks that are there, and to prevent its resurgence. Already you've seen a win for ISIS because we've stopped training. We essentially have shut down training of the Kurdish forces and others who are helping us go after ISIS. The same is is true with NATO, has just announced stopping training as well. So that's already a victory for ISIS. If the U.S. has to leave, then that's an absolute windfall for ISIS, because there's no question they're going to try to come back. We're already seeing them try. There's a tempo of attacks in the last few weeks of something like 20 attacks in Iraq alone in the week of Christmas. So they're trying to do something now. If we leave, we're forced to leave, we're forced to even scale back, there's an opportunity for them to come back.
It's not clear how President Trump would actually view that, though. Obviously, he's been very proud of the destruction of ISIS that has occurred thus far, and has claimed credit for it, not really recognizing the efforts of the prior administration as well, which is certainly the rise of ISIS also happened in the prior administration's watch. But if Iran is then drawn into a conflict with ISIS in Iraq, as they were through these proxy forces early on before there were U.S. troops to also battle ISIS, it's not clear if the president would actually be okay with that.
There's so many ways this could go wrong. You can potentially see the recreation of conditions that existed in 2012 in Iraq, when you essentially had Sunnis feeling they needed to join ISIS or align with ISIS because they were being pressured by some of these Iranian groups. So that could happen again if the U.S. isn't there to referee. That was part of the problem in 2011. We pulled all our forces out, and so the sort of Shiite-friendly Iraqi government allowed some of these Iranian proxies to run roughshod over some of the Sunni groups and really persecuted them. And so there's that potential. And there's just also, just endless opportunities for ISIS to find ways to regroup in areas that are essentially lawless. And there are areas where they can go right now and try to train and try to plan and to do bad things. So those are all opportunities we see coming back right now.
Dexter, it's also been, it's been a fragile couple of years, I guess, good compared to what it was before for Iraq. Over the last couple of years, it's sort of a fragile, with the diminution of ISIS. But those Shia Sunni tensions, which I think are confusing for many people who don't really know the region well, that all still exists as well.
Definitely. And not to confuse everybody more, but one more point on ISIS, the Shiite militias and the Iranians, we were all fighting together against ISIS, the Americans and essentially in Iran, and the Shiite militias that they basically oversee. They were basically cooperating in the fight against ISIS. So all that's kind of like
you say fighting together. I mean, they weren't actually operating in the same units.
No, they weren't. They weren't communicating with each other, but they were coordinating, right. Certainly.
Yeah.